right, you guys. The National League wildcard game wrapped up a short time ago, so now we know our matchups for the NLDS and the ALDS, as the Yankees unfortunately won their game against the Twins. The Diamondbacks won their game against the Rockies, so the Diamondbacks are going to play the Dodgers. Cubs play the Nationals. Of course, my Boston Red Sox start tomorrow against the Houston Astros, and the Yankees will be playing the Indians in the division series. So, a lot of stuff going on. I'm not really going to, like, get in the business of making predictions right now. I mean, I guess I could. But I think it's going to be a really fascinating postseason. I just kind of wanted to talk about that now that we have the matchup solidified. And I really don't know who's going to win a lot of the series. I mean, I like to think I know, but this is a very intriguing postseason. And not that they, you know, there usually is an element of anything can happen in baseball, but this year even more so. I feel like there's not a clear favorite. You know, last year the Cubs were the best team in the league by far, and sure enough they ended up winning. But, you know, that happens some years where you have this one team is like above all the rest, but this year I don't really feel that, although there were a few 100-game winning teams. And for a while there, you know, the Dodgers were on pace to win like 130 games or something crazy, and then they came back to earth, and the Indians won 22 games in a row, so then they look like the best team in the league. The Astros are probably the most consistent team in the league, although even they had some problems. The Red Sox went on a little run. The Yankees were good for a while. So, I mean, all these teams that are in the playoffs right now all have the potential to get to the World Series or win the World Series, and it's going to be remarkable to see because, you know, baseball is not like basketball, you know, where you just need, like, one really good player and it doesn't really matter who else is on the team. You know, you need a complete team. You need a bullpen, a starting rotation, a timely hitting. You know, everybody has to chip in. You know, anybody can be the hero on a given night. It's not, you know, just you have the best player so you win. Or, you know, it's not one team steamrolling everybody else. It's kind of like anything could happen here. The Dodgers, you know, at one point everyone thought they were kind of like the Warriors of baseball, but doesn't look that way now, even though they won their division. And you look at the Diamondbacks, who won the wild card game tonight. They won 93 games and, like, lost their division by 10 games. But, I mean, 93 games is pretty damn good. That's how many games the Red Sox won, and they won their division. So, you have a lot of high-caliber teams. You know, you can't even get caught up in wins at this point. Because when you have a 162-game season, if one team wins, you know, four or five more games than another, I mean, yeah, I guess they're better, but not noticeably better. So, you have all these, you know, the division series alone being incredibly intriguing. And then even after that, I mean, who knows what's going to happen. My gut tells me that the Indians and Astros are going to win their respective series, unfortunately for the Red Sox. I just feel like those teams do have a little bit more. I feel like the Astros lineup is a lot better than the Red Sox lineup, whereas the Red Sox rotation is only a little better than the Astros rotation. So if you're telling me who has the strength over who, you know, I think that the Astros have more firepower and the Red Sox can't. They might not be able to compensate with just Chris Sale, although I'm hoping they can. You go to the Yankees and Indians. I think the Indians are going to win that, but I think it'll be closer than most people think. The Yankees have a good young team, and their bullpen is not to be messed with for the most part. I mean, who knows? Again, you know, the Indians have a pretty good lineup, so they could get to, you know, Canely or Betances or Chapman. They could get to any of those guys. Plus, the Indians have Andrew Miller, Corey Kluber, and a lot of great pitchers themselves. And then you look at the National League, and actually the matchup I'm more intrigued by is the Cubs and Nationals matchup, because the Nationals haven't been able to win in the first round of the playoffs, no matter how good their teams are. They have a starting rotation that you think would be good in a five-game series, because they could have Max Scherzer go twice, Steven Strasburg go. You know, they have three really good pitchers, and, you know, I guess their bullpen's not the best. I'm not going to claim I'm an expert on the Nationals. I just know that their starting rotation's really good. I know there are some health concerns about Bryce Harper right now, but even with that, their lineup is really good. They got a lot of guys batting over 300, a lot of guys with power, you know, so Nationals should be a threat. But then you look across the field there, you got the Cubs, who were last year's champion. They didn't play as well this year, but they had a really good September to get into the playoffs as the National League Central champion. And so the Cubs have that experience. They've got Rizzo, Bryant, the whole group there coming back from last year. They'll probably be hungry to defend their title, I'm sure. And the Nationals haven't really proven yet that they can win a first round. So something's going to give there. You know, either the defending champs are going to get knocked off, or the Nationals are going to just prove again that they can't get out of the first round. So we'll see if tradition changes or not. And, you know, you got the Dodgers and the Diamondbacks. That could go either way, too. I mean, it would be easy for me to just pick the Dodgers, but who knows? The Dodgers have their own kind of issues with the postseason. I know they won last year, but they beat the Nationals, who was like two teams that never get out of the first round. Somebody had to win it. But, you know, this time the Dodgers are going against the Diamondbacks, who are relatively new to the postseason, at least this iteration of the Diamondbacks. They haven't been in the playoffs in a number of years. I don't think anyone on the team, except maybe Goldschmidt, has been in the playoffs. Or Greinke was in the playoffs with the Dodgers. He'll be going up against his old team. So anywhere you look, it's like kind of intriguing matchups. Like I said, my gut tells me it's going to be Astros and Indians playing for the American League pennant. And if I had to pick, I would say it'd be a rematch last year with the Cubs and the Dodgers going for it in the National League. I mean, after that, I don't know. You know, it could be Dodgers-Indians in the World Series, could be Astros-Cubs. I mean, it could be any number of things for the actual World Series. I wouldn't be shocked by any. The only team I would have been shocked by was the Minnesota Twins if they somehow got past the Yankees. That would have shocked me if the Twins made it to the World Series. Other than that, I could even see the Red Sox getting the World Series if they get through the Astros and play the Indians or the Yankees. I mean, I would love to see another Red Sox-Yankees ALCS. I do think that the Red Sox would have a lot of trouble with the Indians, but based on how things went last year, as well as the fact that the Indians got better, they have that really good bullpen. Plus, they have Edwin Encarnacion, Jay Bruce, and more firepower in their lineup than they've had in the past. So if you could say the Indians' lineup was a weakness, you can't say that anymore. And the Red Sox do have some weaknesses as far as, you know, lack of power and just, you know, good starting pitching. I wouldn't say great other than Chris Sale. I'd say, you know, Drew Pomeranz could be good, hopefully will be good. But, you know, if you need Porcello to win a must-win game, I don't really feel good about that because he's just been kind of up and down all year. So, again, anything could happen in the postseason. I'm really looking forward to it. Starts tomorrow afternoon, actually. So I'll be kicking it off with some Red Sox postseason coverage for the first time in a year. Can't wait to do that. Can't wait to see these games and see what happens. The wild card games were pretty entertaining, but I know we got three more rounds of playoffs to go, and they should all be wonderful. So enjoy the postseason, baseball fans. Let's see who wins it.